So normally when we do the Guru Puja, I mean only there's a limited very short time. Otherwise this end of the mandala offering, this purification is very, very important. This request the purification. And then they're taking reciting the vow, Bodhisattva Tantra vow, is extremely important. even though there are people who have not taken vows, but there are also many people who have taken vows, so at the center. So the the Bodhisattva vow, then you see, if somebody broke the vows, then you see, they accept the give up wishing vow and then the heresy, I think. Otherwise, to receive root fall, you need to be qualified with the kuntishi, four mistakes, four shortcomings. If there are all the four shortcomings gathered, then it becomes root fall. Otherwise, if the four mistakes are not gathered, then you don't receive the root fall, except the heresy and the given wishing powers. That the wishing thought, you see. So those two, it doesn't need to be gathered with the four mistakes. As I mentioned, the succession is long version succession. The four mistakes. So not looking at a mistake, the broke bow, you see, but not looking at a mistake. Then it didn't change the action. The desire, the action didn't change. Then they broke the bow, then you can't happy. Then you're happy. Broke the bow, you have been happy on that. Gagu, then no shy and shame. Reasoning oneself, no shy, reasoning others, no shy. Reasoning oneself, no shy, reasoning others, and no shame. So the four things need to be gathered, these four mistakes need to be gathered in order to become fruitful. The Bodhisattva obviously accept the heresy and the wishing vow. So the wishing thoughts. like that. So also, yeah, this. So, so therefore, in case somebody say the vows, but it's about there's also a secondary, secondary vows. So abstaining from the 46 verses. So so it helps to purify. It helps to, by taking the vow again, it helps to restore what has been degenerated, and what has not been degenerated to increase. So the Bodhisattva vow again becomes pure. So it helps for that. And also, if the root vows degenerated, so not yet the four mistakes gathered. So, by repeating the Bodhisattva vow, then it helps to not gather the four mistakes. Kukundishi, it helps to not. To not gather for mistakes. So in that way, then you don't receive the root fall. It helps for that. Even though it's destiny, but it's not, four mistakes are not gathered. By taking again, it helps not to gather these four mistakes. So so you don't receive fall, that helps with that. It's great, it's unbelievable protection. That's one thing. Because these are the basic things for enlightenment, for realization, for enlightenment, samaya vow, see, it's basic thing. But this is the basic foundation for the tantric vow, see. So so then if you know, if you want to unable to protect the Buddhist vow, then you're going to be able to protect the Tantric vow. You know? Then Buddhist vow, foundation for Buddhist vow is the Padmasa vow, you see. So it was a lay vow, and those are lay vows, some of that, you see. Under that, you see. All the ordinary person, ordinary, they say, Tarsic vows, with the friendly priestly vows, whatever. So those things are foundation. Then the Buddhist vow, so it was late in lay vows, you see. And then, so it just comes to succession. So anyway, so then now, so Bodhisattva like this, is very important, you see. Now then, it really helps. So it's really incredible, unbelievable protection, you see. So it makes, see, making my pure, then it helps to, to realization, teaching, enlightenment, you see. So then, the Tantric vow, see, again, same. I think it's my memory is not so good. Yeah. So, there's the Bodhisattva of the truth. Tantric vow, I think, is one. It doesn't need to, heresy or the wishing vow. Do you remember? Tantric vow is only one which doesn't need the four kundis. Four kundis. There's only one, there's not two. Yeah. Bodhisattva of the truth. Do you remember? Huh? Yeah, lokta. Lokta, heresy. So the so need again to receive the four, there's fourteen root falls. So in order to receive root fall, again needs except this one, rock heresy, otherwise needs the four mistakes, kundishi, you know? Four mistakes need to be gathered. So therefore, by taking Tantric vow, so in case something happened, you see, so by taking Tantric vow, then it helps to not gather the four kundis. So that means you don't receive root fall. You don't receive complete root fall, you see. So it's amazing. You know? So it's really unbelievable. Unbelievable, you see. By reciting Tantric vow, so then you see, it helps to not... to not gather the four mistakes. So then you're able to keep that, to not receive it fall, it helps. So unbelievable protection, see. That, and then also, so that, so it's, so it's, you see, doesn't matter, even there are people who have not taken, but because the winds there, whoever read the prayer, see the motivation, this is those who have taken vows, those who have taken Buddhist vow, those who have taken Tantric vow. If the leader, person who leads the prayer say this, you know, then there's no problem with that. There's no problem with the others. Oh, this is about, you know, oh, you know, it's nothing to do with me, you know. So that person get confused. Person who hasn't taken vows, you see. Doesn't have to confuse. If the Wednesday, the person will lead prayer and answer like this. So this those who have taken the vows, okay? So to help to be pure. So you can understand. So people who have not taken vows, this is the problem, you see. If they say it will create confusion to them, so then it helps. So now you see the in the Lamrim, the red commentary, Lamrim Mati, it is mentioned that you know, if one broke tongue to the root vow, you see, how many seconds passes, so you create karma to be in the hell realm for determined number of eons, for determined. How many seconds passes by breaking Tantric vow, Tantric root vow, see? How many seconds passes? There are many eons, you see, because karma to be in the hell realm, suffer. Oh, so therefore, now that this most unbearable. I mean, just even to think that it's almost unbearable. Even just think that it's almost unbearable. See, so that by taking the vow stops that. Yeah, how many seconds passes after having broken the vow? Then there are many eons. It can come. There are many eons. You see, if one second passes, one eon in the hell realm. So that so that it stops the image. So when you take, then it stops. It stops that. So that's can you imagine? Most awesome. I mean this, what protection that is. Can you imagine that? Kind of a, you can't breathe. I mean, you can't breathe. You see something like that. So, by taking down the body stops. So you understand the how the importance, and so like that. Okay. So, the Tantra vow, receiving Tantra vow, it is mentioned that you know you have received Vajra Master initiation. Only if you receive Vajra Master initiation, then Tantra vow is received. So normally that's mentioned. That's why as soon as you can give, in the text mentioned, you can give Tantra vow, but as soon as normally leaves the Tantra vow, the first day during preparation, then give the Buddhist vow. The Tantra vow only given the next day, where there's the Vajra Master initiation. You know, there's something like as a general Vajra disciple initiation, and particularly the Vajra Master initiation, something like that. So when you receive Vajra Master initiation, on that time, they receive Tantra vow. That's what the Gyabji, recently I checked in Gyabji Dhammaloche Rinpoche, mentioned to see. So that seems a common thing. You know, only when you receive Vajra Master initiation, you receive Tantra vow. But then my question is that, you know, the preparation day, you receive Buddhist Tantra vow, then that means you don't receive Tantra vow because Vajra Master initiation is not given that day, you see. So that was my question. So Rinpoche said, Rinpoche referred to, Gyabji Dhammaloche Rinpoche referred to Gyabji Lhajun Dorje Chang, a great Lama in Tibet, Saint Serame. But it holds the four tradition, you know, for the four Tibetan Buddhism, the teachings, initiations. I think it's sort of like the embodiment of Vaitara. So many great Lamas, took initiations. So Gyabji Lhajun Dorje Chang said that when you receive Vajra Master initiation, and that's something, you receive that Tantra vow, so we mentioned that. So quoted like that. So however, if Tantra vow is given the preparation day, then that means you're not received, you see. Only the next day you receive. So I mean, in that case, there is something to check, you see. That definition, you see, can debate or discuss, you see. So however, but the general explanation is like that. So it definitely helped to not gather the four mistakes, gundishi, if you repeat the Tantra vow, you see, then again you're going to practice. So that helps to not gather the four mistakes. So that means you don't receive root, you don't receive complete Tantra root four, you know? So it's unbelievable. That most unbelievable protection. Wow. Because otherwise you can't achieve realizations, you know, so without samaya vow, can't achieve realization, you know? Can't achieve reality, can't achieve enlightenment, so that kind of thing. So, because this importance, I think it's good in the FMT to recite these vows, and then, because there are many people who have taken the vows, so that helps each other. You help others help you, you know, so that it's very good. So let's go. Yeah.
Magnificent and precious Root Guru, please abide on the lotus seat in my crown. Guide me with your great kindness and grant me the realizations of your holy body, speech, and mind. Page 116.
Somewhere I mentioned recently, the last dedication, they say, this marriage to Bambalam Dutta, they gone to the bliss of three times, the spiritual son, you see. That all the holy actions and the prayers be succeeded immediately. Then Rongdo Thamjisam, then I dedicate also dedicate marriage also to preserve the scripture or scripture and realizations long dog. So Dharma, the teaching Buddha comes into scripture and then the say realization. So to preserve in the cause of preserving those two, say then Saragunduda, in all the lifetimes. So there's the Saragunduda's eyes. There in the prayers when I mentioned the I self. But usually I try to dedicate to oneself, then one's family members, and then all the students in this organization, all the supporters, and then so many people who are in different parts of the world, dedicate their life to the organization, serving the organization. It would be a much difficult issue, see, to serve in the organization, say, to benefit from something teaching Buddha. And but also, of course, normally, who will happen, move my promise, pray, whose name is given to me. So, like living person or dead person, see. But, so then say, then all the rest, you see, then all the rest, sentiments, see. Next day, without separation from the four Mahayana Dharma wheels, from the four Mahayana Dharma wheels, so there's a rely upon the give it Thambara Temba, holy beings, you say, that means the virtuous friend. Rely upon holy beings, then you see, then condition, right condition, see, not obstacle, but you know, the family, the place area where you reincarnate, the family, see, you know, all are not which obstacle for your Dharma practice, not but supportive, you see, so conditions. Then also, you see, where you do retreat, you see, place. I mean, also the earth and so forth, you see, water, to not be an obstacle, you see. Harmonize, see, to benefit, not harmful. So English, all the things. Then having collected merits and having done prayers. Not that. So without separation from Mahayana Dharma Wilson, the quality meeting agent sometimes thought as in your meeting, and they may be complete in the. The procedure of the path, you see, renunciation, chance Buddhicitta, and about our right view, and the two stages, the procedure part to be completed. So you pray this, their teachings are on die, so only one somebody, normally to try to, so cover like that. To cover everybody like that, you see, to cover it within that. So then, already you have done a prayer for everybody, you see, if you do that, you know. So including your family, you know, all the whole organization, this sort of, the last ones, or sentient beings, you see, like that. Because anyway we're doing prayer, so then you pray only one service. Then the prayer becomes very limited, you know, so it's, that's a cover, including prayer, you see. Then, very good. I think the Chinese Lama, chanting. The benevolent kneel looks like tortured by somebody. I think with all the prayers and the programs, tortured. somewhere can be good, yeah. But it sounds like very somebody tortured, and very heavily tortured, and very sad. So that's what but I can say. That's my wrong. Food. You see, for example, food for somebody very tasty, for somebody very bad, for somebody very tasty. You know, it's not simple, but so I think what's no, it's good, very good. No, it's very good. So just make it a little bit pleasant. And especially the thought transformations, you know, if they have problems, you know, they something to relate and something to help. Anyway, the plants is the whole path from Advent. But the Donglen, the Tenaji Lama Tsuji, so that one was chanted. That one, you see, do the rest in English, but that one was chanted 3 times. Chanted very slowly, not in a rush. Chanted very slowly 3 times. Then, then you can do Donglen meditation with compassion, taking other suffering and causes and delusion karma. And then, by general loving kindness, you give happiness, all the merits, happiness after enlightenment, all the merits. You see, all the three time merits for all sentient beings, you know. Number of self, number of hunger, number of animal, number of simian, number of sura, asura, intermediate beings. To every sentient being, you see. So you offer, so the, including your body, you know, possession, everything. So, see, your body, your possession, every single thing, give. So the each time when you take, the suffering, all the suffering causes and, you know, everything, the, you know, numberless merits, you know, from every sentient being. So wow, numberous merits you collect, the purification, you know, unimaginable purification. You see, the so many eons when you come again, people are stronger, you generate compassion. You see, then when you give, you are giving your all the three time merits. Can you imagine all the three time merits in the past? And then all the results happen after enlightenment. You get everything. Then your body, all your possessions, every single thing, give way to every sentient being. So you see, so with each of these, you know, with each merit, with your body, with the result of happiness, with each possession, you know, with everything, then it's given to numberless sentient beings. So can you imagine the numberless, you see, I mean the cause of enlightenment, you see. Wow, you know, with the material possession, numberless. Because you give to numberless sentient beings, you see. Every possession, you see. Then your body, numberless sentiments. So with each thing, you create numberless merits, numberless cause of enlightenment, you see. So this not the most unimaginable, see, in such short time, you know. It's like, so that, you see. most amazing, so the, unbelievably fortunate, see, purification and how much merit you collect, so that. So that's an idea, you see, you do all English, but that part, chant slowly, you know, very slowly, then do that. And then you see, the idea is to do meditation along with that, not just on the chanting, but dongling meditation, you see. So it's fantastic, it becomes fantastic practice. So we say, it makes worthwhile, they have it, that we have met Mahayana teaching. It makes it worthwhile, you see. Okay, so that's it. You need Lama Sangha, Lama Chö?
Food blessing. Okay, food blessing is, everyone knows, I think. Om, 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 Om.